of the shooting from the riot police toward the demonstrators not being hurt. The man who has been watching all of this for us and reporting on it is our CNN Moscow Bureau Chief, Steve Hurst. Steve?
Ralph, most recently, Alexander Rutskoi, you see a live picture now from our roof camera at the CNN Bureau. Alexander Rutskoi, the ousted vice president and Afghan war hero, was mixing in the crowd with a bullhorn trying to organize his forces behind the White House. That picture now live from behind the White House. Organize his people for an attack that he has ordered upon the Russian, the Moscow mayor's office, and the Russian broadcasting center, Astankino, across town. The crowd seems to have diminished somewhat behind the White House. Apparently, these people moving off in other directions. These attacks that have been called for by Rutskoi and Ruslan Hazlov, the chairman of the parliament, who even called for an attack on the Kremlin, very inflammatory speeches in what has so far been a war of words that got a bit violent just a few minutes ago as these demonstrators broke through police cordons. Now we have another live picture from another vantage point. This is a skyscraper behind the White House. And you can see the crowd there milling around still. Some of the water trucks that have been brought in as barricades being moved around also. From this vantage point several nights ago, we showed you the overwhelming Interior Ministry force that formed around the Russian White House, the Parliament building, now in the 13th day of what I would call a siege. The 100 or so deputies still hold up inside, led by Ruslan Hazbulatov and Alexander Rutskoi. We've had no official reaction from President Boris Yeltsin about this latest activity. It said 5,000 or so demonstrators broke through police barrier after police barrier, ran a gauntlet of tear gas and rubber bullets, moving some 4 miles, perhaps, from October Square back to the White House, where they've retaken their ground, their demonstrating position. There is a great deal of confusion. You see a line of police there in the lower part of that corner, the corner of that picture from our live camera behind the White House. The Interior Ministry troops sent out to block these demonstrators in complete disarray after they broke through line after line of them on their march to the White House. Ralph?
Steve, is there any indication that any of these demonstrators have moved toward the mayor's office as they were told to do?
Well, they are at the mayor's office. It's just a matter of if they can organize to attack. That's a picture of the mayor's office right now, the former Comic-Con building. It sits right at the end of the bridge over the Moscow River here on Kutuzovsky Prospect, where our bureau is. No sign yet of attack, but there is a clear sign that these people are trying to organize something under the direction of Alexander Rutskoi, who called for an attack on the mayor's office, for an attack on Astankino, the Russian broadcasting center that is in the hands of Boris Yeltsin and has been used by his people clearly against what is really a fairly small group of people causing all of this trouble. Let's see, even if there are 10,000 people out there, Moscow is a city of 9 million people, and if we could move our camera farther on down the road, you would see people going about their business, shopping in the city, aside from this small area around the White House at this point, is completely calm.
You said earlier, Steve, that the riot police were clearly outnumbered by the demonstrators. Have they brought in any more forces?
Would you please repeat, Ralph?
You mentioned earlier that the riot police were outnumbered by the demonstrators. Any indication of any new forces being moved in?
Not at this point. We don't see indications of that. I think that there are plenty of forces billeted in the mayor's building, which is just across the street from the White House, and also across the river at the Hotel Ukraine. There's a crowd moving towards the mayor's office. You can see smoke in this picture. I don't know what the source of that is. Some indications that might have been an APC, an armored personnel carrier, starting up. They have huge diesel engines, and they would give off billows of smoke like that. This crowd now moving toward, there's the APC, you can see it now. Two of them moving away from the mayor's office. One more parked with its engine running as the crowd moves by it, up a ramp that goes to the mayor's building, the Moscow Municipal Building. A huge crowd of people heading towards that building. And there are a lot of troops, we believe, inside the building. All of them are. You see the armored personnel carrier is now moving away from the scene. People running, mainly moving towards the building, some others moving away.
What kind of leadership did these demonstrators have, Steve? Obviously, it was Kozlov and Rutskoi who fired them up with their speeches a while ago, but who's leading them on the ground, do you suppose?
The people leading them on the ground are a dangerous group of people. They're mercenaries. They're people who are Afghan war veterans, people perhaps discharged from the military during the coup for their participation in the coup. They are former soldiers who fought in places like Moldova, where there were bitter ethnic battles. Also, they've been fighting in Nagorno-Karabakh. Is that gunfire we hear from that camera?
Yeah, you could hear from our camera location that you're seeing the picture from now behind the White House what appeared to be gunshots.
Steve, could you help us a little bit from your vantage point? Where is this crowd heading now? Where are they moving towards?
They're moving towards the Moscow mayor's office, which is just across the street from the White House.
You can see those water tank trucks moving. That is the street that runs in front of the new American Embassy compound. There is the picture now from where I am standing on the roof of the CNN building. That's the Moscow mayor's building. Just to the left of that is the White House. And between the White House and, stop right there, that is the American Embassy, that red building, the new American Embassy compound. A lot of the activity going on is in clear view of diplomats who live inside that compound.
The demonstrators were told to storm the mayor's office, but were they told to do anything once they got inside?
They were told to attack the mayor's office. Ruslan Hazvalatov said that there is a beehive of criminals inside that building. That is where the Interior Ministry, loyal still to Boris Yeltsin, had billeted a few thousand troops as this crisis grew toward a head when a cordon was put around the White House late last week. What they meant by an attack, what was to happen, when and if they got inside the building, we don't know, but I suppose the intention is to occupy the mayor's office and to evict the soldiers. Now, how that could happen, you have a group of basically unarmed civilians, a lot of older men and women in this crowd of demonstrators, what they could possibly do against the troops that we believe are still in that building with their guns, we just don't know. People still flooding across the street towards the mayor's building.
Dave, I'm going to ask you to stand by for a moment. We are going to continue our live coverage from Moscow right after we take this short break. We'll be right back.